Hare Krishna, welcome for the discussion on Bhagavad Gita chapter number 2. And today we are going to discuss verses from 47 to 49. Okay, and especially we are going to see how one should practice this Nishkama Karma Yoga or Buddhi Yoga. So let us start with today's verse, verse number 47.
कर्मण्येवाधिकारस्ते मा फलेषु कदाचन मा कर्मफल हेतुर्भूर्माते संगोस्त्व कर्मणि.
सो द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्स इज लाइक दिस. कर्मण्येवाधिकारस्ते मीन्स यू हैव राइट टू परफॉर्म योर प्रिस्क्राइब्ड ड्यूटीज. कर्मण्येवाधिकारस्ते मा फलेषु कदाचन, बट यू आर नॉट एंटाइटल्ड फॉर द फ्रूट्स ऑफ योर एक्शंस. देन कृष्णा टेल्स मा कर्म फल हेतुर्भूर, नेवर कंसिडर दैट यू आर द कॉज ऑफ द रिजल्ट्स ऑफ योर एक्शंस. एंड एट लास्ट कृष्णा टेल्स माते संगोस्व कर्मणि, एंड यू शुड नॉट बी अटैच टू नॉट परफॉर्मिंग योर ड्यूटी. Specifically here Krishna is telling these four statements in this very important verse and very famous verse. So we are going to discuss few more things on this particular verse. First thing, we are going to try to understand this karma. So there are actually three kinds of karma: karma, and then vikarma, and akarma. So what is karma? Karma is what is mentioned here, the prescribed duties which are prescribed according to one's nature. Okay, second one is vikarma. The vikarma are the capricious activities or the duties or activities which are not prescribed by any authority. And third one is akarma, which is basically inaction or not performing one's prescribed duties. Okay, and this karma is also having three subdivisions. Like one is nitya karmas or routine duties, and one is kamya karmas or desired activities, and the last one is emergency duties. So here Krishna is trying to explain to Arjuna that you have to perform your prescribed duty, but you should not be attached to the results or fruits of your action. Why? Because if one is attached to the fruits of one's actions, then he gets implicated in the life or cycle of karma, and causes the material bondage. It is does not lead one to liberation or salvation. Hence Krishna is advising here Arjuna that not to be attached to the fruits of your actions. So here Arjuna's decision of non-participation in the battle is also another side of attachment. That's why Krishna is specifically telling here Arjuna that don't be attached to not perform your duty. Okay, so now we will see in the next verse, verse number 48.
Yogastha kuru karmani sangam tyaktva dhananjaya siddhya siddhyo samo bhutva samatvam yoga uchyate.
So here Krishna is telling to Arjuna, perform your duty, O Arjuna, and abandon all attachment to success and failure, and do in equanimity. Such equanimity is yoga. So this verse actually defines very nicely Nishkama Karma Yoga. First thing Krishna tells that you perform your duty or karma, that is karma, and sangam tyaktva, without any attachment, that is Nishkama Karma, and this is called as yoga. Krishna is telling Nishkama Karma Yoga. So basically again and again this message is coming that one should not be very much attached to the fruits of one's actions. This victory or defeat is the Krishna's concern, and we need to just follow the instruction or direction of Krishna, and that is real yoga. That is what we understand from this verse and many verses before and after. Okay, so now we will discuss the next verse in this sequence.
Durena hyavaram karma buddhi yoga dhananjaya buddhau sharanam anvicha kripana falahetavah.
So here Krishna is telling to Arjuna, O Dhananjaya, keep all the abominable activities far away by the help of Buddhi Yoga, devotional service. And not only that, he is telling, in that consciousness you surrender unto the Lord. And those who are very much attached to the fruits of their activities, they are actually misers. Now here Krishna is directly again calling the people who are attached very much to the fruits of their actions as misers, because of their attachment they are getting implicated and more entangled in the material bondage. So that is how we understand that Buddhi Yoga is highest and better, and Krishna is recommending that over sakam karma or just acting for the sake of fruits or results. Okay, so in the next video we are going to see that Krishna is going to explain further in the coming verses the benefits of practicing this Buddhi Yoga. So that we will see in the next video. Till then, thank you very much for watching. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.